Hello children, I'm Ruda from IPSA. I am your storyteller for today. I will be telling you all a fairy tale. Do you all know what a fairy tale is? Fairy tale is a story often intended for children that have fanciful and wondrous characters such as elves in Snow White and dwarfs. Then we have goblins, wizards, and not necessarily fairies. These tales are passed from one storyteller to another before being recorded in books. And today's story is on a fairy tale in which we don't have a fairy but a magic fish. So children, let's begin with the story of magic fish. So children, now let's listen to the story of magic fish carefully. Once upon a time, there lived a man in a village named Brahmapur with his wife. The fisherman used to be very happy. He used to live very happy, but his wife used to always be very unhappy and sad. But the fisherman used to make her wife happy in each and every ways. So he used to go to a cliff to catch the fishes. So children, do you all know what is the meaning of cliff? Yes, cliff means the edge, corner of the sea. So children, have you all seen a sea anytime? Yes, water, sea, lake, river. Yes. So, as we see the rocks there, we see big, big stones, right? So, that part is known as cliff. So, what the fisherman used to do? He used to go and catch fishes there. So that if he gets fishes for his wife, she would be happy. So, every time what he used to do is, he used to catch fishes and he had a big rod to catch the fishes. So, he used to catch the fishes and get it for his wife. But you know what wife used to do? She used to demand for more fishes. She used to say, these fishes are so less. You didn't get me more than this. I want more fishes. And she used to demand a lot. And if sometimes he used to get mangoes for her. But the wife used to demand for another fruit. Like, you know, she used to offer for peaches, you know, and many other fruits like that. So, but as the fisherman always wanted his wife to be happy, so he kept on going to the cliff side and catch the fish. But now let's see one day what happens. One day the fisherman went to the cliff again to catch the fish. So he kept his rod in the water, but It went on, but he didn't get any of the fishes. So he was so tired sitting there. He thought, oh, I'm not even getting a single fish today. So what should I do? If I go home without the fishes, my wife, the lady here, she's going to get angry a lot because she's already unhappy. So what he did, he thought, okay, I'll wait for some more time and let's see whether I get a fish or no. So he waited there for some more time. So after some time, what happened? You know, children, what happened? Come, let's see what happens. The fisherman was sitting with his rod and the rod got very heavy. Oh, so what happened? The rod was very heavy. So he thought, come, let's check what is there inside, whether I've caught a fish. So he pulled his rod out and he saw what? A big golden and red color fish. Wow! See? This fish is so beautiful. Yes, can you see the color, children? It is in golden and red color. So, as he saw this fish, a surprise that this fish is so big. One more thing was, a surprise that a fisherman got is, this fish was talking to him. Oh, isn't that a surprise, children? So, the fisherman was very surprised and excited to know that how can a fish talk? Children, please tell me that have you ever seen a fish talking? I have never seen a fish talking. But this golden and red color fish started talking to the fisherman. And let's see what this fish is saying to the fisherman. So the fishes come here and the fish is saying to the fisherman, "Hey, please don't catch me, okay? Because if you take me, I am not going to taste good. You are not going to enjoy me eating because I am an enchanted prince." Oh, so children, can you see this? What the fish is saying? "I am an enchanted prince." Oh, the fish is calling himself a prince. Oh, so what is he saying next? Let's see. "I am not going to taste well. So make sure that you put me back to the water inside and I shall give you a gift. If you let me go, this is a chant that you need to say if you want me to come and grant your wish." So what is the fish saying? That there is a chant. If you want to grant a wish to me, there is a chant you have to come and say. So what is the chant, children? Come, let's see what the fish is telling us about. "Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish." Okay, so what is the fisherman thinking now? So he's thinking, okay, if he's saying that he's going to grant me a wish, so it's better I put him back in the sea. I'll put him back in the water so that he can help me in future. So he says, okay, fine. So he puts the fish back to the sea. So now, children, as you all know, the fish has gone back to the sea. The fisherman is going home back because he has to go and tell his wife about this so that she'll be happy and she'll get excited about this. So come, let's see what happens next. So the fisherman started going to his hut. Okay, they are living in a small hut. So he reaches there. So now let's see what the fisherman is saying to his wife. "Hey, how are you?" She's saying, "I'm fine." "Okay, so I want to tell you something about today." So now she's a bit excited, like, what happened? But before that, now she's asking him something. "Where are the fishes?" "Yes, you came so late. You're already very late and there are no fishes today. No fishes for dinner. How am I going to cook?" "Yes, where is it? Tell me." Now the fisherman is going to tell her about that surprise which he saw in the sea. So let's see what is he going to say. "Do you know, I met a big enchanted prince in the sea and it was a big golden and red color fish." Oh, so she's asking, "Where is it? I can't see. It is not in your hand. It is not in the bag. Where is that big golden fish?" So now let's see what the fisherman is saying. "No, I did not bring the golden and red color fish with me because he's a enchanted prince." Oh, see, now the fisherman has told his wife that he's an enchanted prince. And he told me that if you want me to take me home, that is not going to be okay because you people will not enjoy me eating because I'm a prince and it is not going to taste good. So it's better you put me back in the sea and if you grant me a wish, I can make your wish come true. So I left him back in the sea. So now the wife is again very unhappy and sad and she's angry on him. Okay, so but now as she comes to know that if she grants a wish, the fisherman will go and ask for the wish and that fish is going to make the wish come true. So now the wife is granting a wish to his husband that go and ask the fish about this. So what is she going to say? Let's see. So children, now let's see what the wife is going to grant a wish for his for her. Okay, so let's see what is she going to say to the fisherman. So the wife is going to say, okay, so as you met a talking fish, now you have to please go to him. You have to go to the prince and tell him that my wife is not at all happy and I'm very unhappy. So I want a very big wooden cottage. So as we all know, children, that these two are staying in a small hut. Now she wants to stay in a big wooden cottage. So the fisherman is bit hesitant, like he's wondering, he's thinking, how will I go and ask the fish about this wish? But as we all know, the fisherman always wanted his wife to be happy. So he went to the sea again. So let's see what is he going to say to the golden and red color fish. Come. So now the cliff is going back, the fisherman is going back to the cliff. Okay, so the cliff is come. Okay, now as we can see, the fish is in the sea. So the fisherman has reached there. And now, children, do you remember what the fish had told him? What that prince had told him? What he has to say? He had given him a chant, okay, to say. So that whenever he'll be saying that, the fish is going to come and make his wish come true. So do you all remember what it was? Yes? So let's help the fisherman to call the fish back out. Okay? So deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant my wish. So here comes the fish. So the prince is here. So now let's see what the prince is going to say. Yes, tell me, what happened? What is your wish? So now the fisherman is going to say what the wife has told him to ask. The fisherman is saying, my wife is very unhappy. She wants a big wooden cottage. So now what is the fish going to say? Fine. Already she has got the big wooden cottage. Please go. Her wish is granted. And again, now the fish is going to go back to the sea. So now the fisherman is a bit excited. So he went running to the house. And he gets a big surprise. What? That his wife has got a big, huge wooden cottage. So now the fisherman is going to ask something to his wife. Let's see what is he going to ask. So, are you happy now? Now what is the wife saying? See, I am happy, but this is very beautiful. Okay, the house, the big wooden cottage is very beautiful. But now I have another wish. I want a big, huge palace. Oh, see children, as we can see, she's still not much happy, right? She's saying that the wooden cottage is beautiful, but as we can see, she's not happy. She wants a big huge palace now. So now what is the fisherman going to say? Let's see. But how can I go back and ask him for the wish again? No. The fisherman's wife is saying, no, I don't know anything. You have to go and tell him that I'm not happy with this. I'm unhappy. I want a big huge palace. Okay. So as we all know, the fisherman always wants his wife to be happy. So again, the fisherman is going to go back to the sea. So as he reaches there, so he has to call him again. So let's help him once again, because now this is the second time he has reached there near the sea. So let's help him. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Yes, so the fish is back here. Now what is the fish going to say? Let's see. Yes, what is it now? What is your wish? My wife is wanting a big huge palace. Please, can you grant my wish? Now, what is the fish going to say? Let's see. Fine. Go back. Go back. The wish is granted. Already, your wife has got a big huge palace. Wow, isn't this surprise, children? Isn't this beautiful? Yes, he just asks for the wish and it is already granted. So let's see. Now again, the fisherman is running and going back to the house to see whether she has got a palace or no. Yes, so he has reached back to his home. And what is this? Wow, such a big huge palace with the brass doors, and there are many servants also with this lady, the wife, and she's sitting on a throne with a crown. Wow, see, she wanted a palace, she got a palace, and she got a beautiful crown also, and she was looking very pretty, children. So now the husband is again asking her, did you like the palace? So now let's see, what is she going to say? So, did you like the palace? Are you happy now after being a queen? She's saying, well, I am happy, but not much. Now, I have another wish for me. Oh, so, see, as we can see, she's still not happy with the palace. Now, what does she want? Let's see. She's saying, please go and tell the fish that still I'm not happy. I'm very unhappy and I want to be an empress. Now I need a empress. So now even the fisherman is a bit upset and sad that how many times I'll go and ask the fish for my wish again and again. So, but as we all know that he wants his wife to be always happy and smiling. So again he's going to go back to the sea. So let's see, what is he going to do? He's going. He reaches the cliff. Now again we have to help him, children, because we have to call the fish back. Now this is the third time that he's coming and asking for the wish, to grant a wish. Let's call the fish because he's very tired, no, children? So we'll help him, okay? Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Here is the fish back again. Yes, tell me, what is it now? Prince, my wife wants to grant a wish again. So, what is her wish now? She wants an empress now. Oh, see, she's offering one more thing. Fine, already her wish is granted. Oh, see, children, now again, the wish is granted. So now, again the fisherman is going back home. He went on going. As he reaches, what does he see? Wow, the beautiful wife is there with the empress, with so many servants. And now she has got a big diamond crown also. In first, like palace, she was having a crown, but she was not having diamonds in it. But now, she has diamonds. And you know what, children? In the palace, she had brass doors. But now, she has golden doors for her empress. So, isn't it so beautiful, children? Yes? So, now the fisherman is going to ask her something. Let's see, what is he going to ask? Okay. So, my wife, are you happy now? Let's see, what is she saying now? I don't know. Let's see. I don't know whether I'm happy or no. Oh, see, now she has got so many things, but still she's saying that she doesn't know whether she's happy or no. So children, as we saw that She got so many things, but still she is not so happy. And after asking, what is she saying? Let's see. I don't know whether I'm happy or no. So as that night they went to sleep, the fisherman was so tired that he went asleep. But children, you know what? The wife was not ready to sleep. She was not getting the sleep. She was awake for whole night and she was thinking, like, what would be the next wish that I can grant and it can come true. So she kept on thinking, she kept on thinking. But in this things, a week passed. Okay, after a week she was so tired, thinking that she went asleep. What did she do? She went asleep. But what happened next? Let's see. The wife went to sleep, and as she went to sleep, the sun rose. So she couldn't finish her sleep. And that morning, she was so angry and she said, how dare this sun rose so early? The sun should know that I haven't slept for a week because I was thinking about the wish. How can this happen? So she got so angry and she thought of granting a wish of what? Let's see, what is she going to grant the wish to her husband? So the wife is saying, I want to be unknown. I want to be almighty. So what does she want to be, children? Almighty. Do you know what almighty means? Almighty means God. God means who has created sun, moon, stars. Yes. So what does she want to be? What is she granting? She wants to be almighty. She wants to be unknown. So what the husband is saying? What? Are you okay? What are you saying? How can we grant this wish? And how is it possible? That is not possible at all. Please don't grant such wishes. So as we know that she is very angry and upset, so husband, as we all know, the fisherman always wants his wife to be happy. So he says, okay, fine, I'll go to the fish, I'll go to the prince and grant this wish. Let's see whether it's going to come or no. So again the fisherman starts going to the sea. So he reaches the cliff. Now this is the fourth time, children, that he has been there. So please let's help him to call the prince. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. So you're the fish again. Yes, tell me, what is your wish now? So the fisherman is saying, my wife is still unhappy as she couldn't sleep. As the sun rose, she's angry and she wants to be almighty. Oh, now what happens? Let's see. Your wish is granted. Please go. See, children, this wish is also granted. So now what happens? Let's see. The fisherman reaches home. As he reaches home, he just sees the palace. There is no wife, there are no servants, there is no crown, nothing but the empty palace, the empty empress. So he is very sad, very upset. So now for the fifth time, he is going to go back to the sea and wish for himself. Come, let's see, what is he going to wish? So he is going. So as he reaches there, now he has to call him back. This is the fifth time where the fisherman is going to call the fish again. So let's him help for the last time, children, please. Come. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. Deep in the sea, up in the sky, come my magic fish, grant me a wish. So now the fish is back here. The prince is saying, yes, tell me, what is it now? What is your wish? So the fisherman replies now, I want my wife back because she is my wife. I want to be happy with her. I can't live without my wife. So please bring my wife back. What is the fish going to say? Let's see. Okay, your wish is granted, said the fish. So children, did you see? The fish has granted the wish again. So now the fisherman returns back to his home. And what does he see? That his wife is back home. And she's standing there with the small hut where they used to live, which is near the sea. So children, now the wife has also realized that she was wrong. So what is she saying now? Let's see to her husband. I'm sorry, I have realized that whatever we have, we need to be happy in that things only. We have to be happy in whatever we have and we have to thank God for it. So children, as we saw this story, from that onwards, they both lived very happily. So children, what is the moral of the story? So the moral of the story is, happiness lies in the simplest of things. So my dear children, what did we learn from this story? That we always need to be happy with whatever we have and should thank God and our parents to bless us with the things which we have got. So now I hope, children, you all might have loved and liked the story. So please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you all next session in the next story. Bye. Take care.